Now that we've seen the basics of what Rust has to offer in the form of collections, let's see how to use them in code. We'll start by creating a new library project and opening it up in VS Code. Let's say we're creating an enrollment system for a school. First, we'll create a student struct. We'll give the student one field, name, with type string. We'll annotate our struct with a derive attribute that automatically derives implementations for the partial eek and eek traits. Don't worry about the details of traits and deriving. This simply gives us the ability to test that two structs are equal if their fields are equal. We'll start by creating a vector of students using the vec macro. The macro is shorthand for creating the vector and then pushing each element onto it one at a time. At any time, we can push more elements onto the vec using the push method. We can easily access the students by index using square brackets. Be aware that this attempts to take ownership over the item. This will cause compilation errors since we're not allowed to take ownership over the item since the student's vec itself has ownership of that item. To get around this, we borrow the item instead of taking ownership by adding an ampersand. Accessing an index that is not present in the vec will compile just fine, but will panic at runtime. If you need to access a specific item in a vec, you may prefer to use the get method, which returns an optional reference to the item. If no item exists at the index provided, none will be returned. Vectors also provided a convenient way to iterate through the contents of the vec by using the iter method, which returns an iterator. Iterators are a whole topic on their own. They provide rich ways of filtering, mapping, and combining data together. Now that we have our list of students, we may wish to store them in a way that allows us to access them by the courses they're enrolled in. For that, we can use a hash map. In order to use the hash map, we need to bring it into scope by adding a use statement. This brings the hash map type into scope for our use. We then can create a hash map and store our students into a class. Let's say biology. We do this by creating the hash map and then inserting. This gives a hash map with owned string keys and a vec of student values. If we want to access all the students in a course, we can use the get method just like on vec. This gives us a reference to the vec of students stored in our hash map. It's important to remember that the hash map owns its keys and values, just like a vec owns its elements. This means when we access elements inside these collections, we will only get back references to them. If we need ownership over those items, we need to remove them from the collections, which we can do by using the remove method. Rust collections have many rich APIs associated with them. Check out the Rust documentation for more info.